Let's take a look at how easy it is to hook up a Pololu Motor Shield for your DCC++ project. Right here, I have it hooked up to my Mega. Got my package in from Pololu. I got it a little bit faster than I thought I would. I'm going to show you how to wire up this Pololu Motor Shield. Now, what makes this Pololu Motor Shield different than the Arduino Motor Shield? It's actually 3 amps per channel, where the Arduino is 2 amps per channel. This is more complicated than the Arduino. On the Arduino, all you have to do is plug it in and put 2 jumpers on it, or if you're using a Mega, just 1 jumper on it. I'm going to show you the jumpers you have to put on here, and you also have to solder the headers on here. So you see, you get the motor shield, you get these three. I put them together, they slide just together, but these are your terminals right here. Here is your jumper, and we'll just store it on the Pololu. You got the header. You got, 2 6-pin, 2 8-pin, and a 10-pin. You don't use all of them. I think you just use 1 6-pin, 2 8, and 1 10 on there. And then you have these, which we will not use. We'll just use that for the jumper, but we're not going to jumper both of the pins on there. We're just going to store the jumper on one of the pins. And that jumper is just like cutting a trace on the Arduino. Now, on the Pololu, there's some traces on the back that we're going to have to cut. So I'll show you what those are also. Before we get started, I'm going to show you the wiring diagram for all the jumpers on here. Now, this one is for the Arduino Uno, and you can see the jumpers over here. You have 2 jumpers that you put on the header, and then you have these 2 wires that are on the header, and then you solder them on the pins on the side. Now, that's for the Uno, and this is for the Mega. And you can see on the jumpers on here, just like with the Arduino Motor Shield, the jumpers are in a different place on the Uno and on the Mega. So there's the Uno, there's the Mega. So we'll get started with that right now. I have the Motor Shield sitting up on top of the Mega just to make sure which pins to solder my headers on, and it looks like we need to solder it on the outside. I'm going to use the breadboard as a guide so we can solder the header on there. Row number 4 on there. So we're just going to put these in here, and we're just going to put these in here. And what we do is we turn this over, how the headers fit on there. Okay, we have a 10, 2 8s, and 1 6 that we're going to be using on there. Okay, so you see how I have it on there, and you got a little bit of jiggle in there, but that gets us to where that's a little crooked, so I can move that back just a little bit. And you see how easy it is to mess it up. Okay, there. We got it. Got it sitting there like we want it, so we're all ready to solder this. I'm not going to put you through the agony of watching me solder all the components onto this motor shield. If you'd like to see how I solder, I have a few videos that I did a while back on soldering. I'll leave a link in the description for those videos. Okay, I took it off of there, got it all soldered in, and it fits perfect. I have it all lined up and pushes down in there real nice. So what we're going to do now is we're going to put in the pins over here. Now you see on here, you got these little Mickey Mouse. I'll turn it this way so you can see the little Mickey Mouse heads on there. You got 1 square Mickey Mouse head on there. That's the ground wire. But what we're going to do, we're going to mount this on here. We're going to put the pins in the larger holes and move them towards the front to solder them in there like that. Okay, and you'll see why when I turn this over. Because that way you could see the printing on the circuit board right there. and you don't interfere with these LEDs on either side. If you tried to put them in the smaller holes towards the back, you'll cover up the printing, and whatever side you put it on, you'll cover up one of the LEDs. So you put it in the larger hole in the Mickey Mouse head and push it forward, and we'll solder it in there like that. Now, I told you I was going to put the jumper, the pin for the jumper in there, and that goes right here. We're going to take this jumper and we're just going to store it on there. We're just going to put it on one pin because we don't want to send the voltage from here, the high voltage on here, back down onto the Arduino. Now that we have everything soldered on here, we have the headers on there, got the terminals, and we got the little pins in there for the jumper. And remember, you don't use the jumper, you're just using that to store that jumper in there. We'll take a look at the diagram that I showed you before, and there's some traces on the back of here, and we'll do that with an X-Acto blade, just like you do on the Arduino motor shield for the VIN. You're going to be cutting three of them on here, and I'll just bring up the diagram again on the screen. You can see on this 8-pin cluster right here, the furthest two pins is the trace for pin number 4. You want to cut that one right there. And then you have a 4-pin cluster right here. What you want to do is cut both traces on there. You have 4 pins, 10 and 12. So those are the 3 that you are going to cut. They are on the bottom side. To make sure you got all the way through on your cutting your trace, use a meter on there. And what I did was I put it on audible so I don't have to keep looking back on the meter. Now, on the Arduino boards, you just barely have to cut on the trace to get it cut. But this one's a little bit harder. It took me about 3 tries before I got all the way through. But these are the 3 right here. These 2 that are together, and the one with their, when there's 8 together, it's all the way at the end. That's the number 4. So you just put your meter on there to make sure that you cut all the way through that trace on there. And make sure you have it on the audible. Now we're ready for the jumpers. Now let me bring you back over to the diagrams. The jumpers on here, as you can see, are between pin 5 and pin 8. This is for the Uno. And pin 7 and pin 10. If you're doing a Mega like me, your jumper is going to be between 2 and 8 and 7 and 12. But let's just take a look at the Uno for right now. Okay, those are the 2 jumpers there. You're also going to want to put some wires from 9 and 11 down to D2 and M2 PWM. And what I did was, instead of putting it into the header over here, what I did was I soldered them underneath. Well, I soldered them on the surface, but the wires I ran underneath. So I have pin 9 going to D2 right here, and I have this pin 11 going down to M2 PWM on the bottom of the motor shield. Here's what mine looks like. I just have 2 wires that I jumped from the pins on the top. You could also use the DuPont jumper wires to do that. And then I soldered these 2 wires. I actually soldered them on this side and routed them on the bottom so they would be out of the way. But you could put them on top any way that you want to do it. But that's all there is for adding components to the Pololu. Now it's time to go look at the sketch. Since I do a lot of experiments with it, I rename the sketch to what motor shield that I'm going to be using. So on this one, I have DCC PP Mega Pololu. So we have to come over to Configure H, and you'll see down here, define motor shield type according to the following table. So this one was originally at 0, so we're using the Pololu now, so we just change that to 1, and we can go up here to verify, Now that we have this configured for the Pololu, let's upload it. Before you compile your sketch, make sure you have all your settings for the component that you're using. Like on mine, mine's the Mega. So you can see over here that I have it set up for the Mega 2560, the processor at Mega 2560, and the COM port. And once you have that, everything should go smoothly. I ran the Motor Shield on JMRI, hooked it up like I normally do with the Mega, and all the tests that I did on there were satisfactory. It ran the locomotive and it did the CVs without a hitch. Now, this is a good Motor Shield here. It's even smaller than the Arduino and it's more powerful because it'll handle 3 amps per channel on there. Here's what it looks like on the Mega. I'm going to show you some photos, some close-up photos on here, just to give you an idea of what everything looks like on here, because the video camera doesn't do justice. Even if I put it close up to the camera, you can't see really well. So these photos right here will help you out very much. So that's all I have for now on the Pololu. We're going to have some more projects coming up. Even the Rock Creek back here, we're going to have that coming out pretty soon. So keep an eye out for that. So until the next time, we'll see you.